The Pleiadian Mission, A Time of Awareness. Part 2, The Long Struggle of Mankind. Just as the Pleiadian spiritual leaders had foreseen, it had taken thousands of years for the people of Earth to once again rebuild their great civilization and regain their technology. Years of extraterrestrial intervention by many visiting races had created a world mixed with spirit forms from many different worlds. Most planets that develop human life have, by nature, only one race that evolves at much the same pace, so the process of developing a peaceful society comes easily. But here on Earth, normal evolution has been interrupted by human beings, spirit forms, that have come from many parts of the galaxy, creating a planet of mixed colors, sizes, and levels of evolution. It is not surprising that we have so many problems here on Earth, considering our world is such a mixture of people of different spiritual ages. Instead of being a planet where most people are of the same approximate spiritual age and are learning the same lessons of life at about the same time, we are a world mixed with young and old spirits, who all need different knowledge and have diverse backgrounds and spiritual memories. Most of the population of Earth came from the constellation Lyra, while others have come from the Vega section of the sky, the Barnard Star, and some from star systems called Sirius and Orion. This has created a spiritual imbalance that has made Earth a world dominated by prejudice, hate, and anger. More than 11,000 years have passed since the inception of the Pleiadian mission and the arrival of the old spirit form from Lusin. He has died many lifetimes in order to gently guide us towards a better understanding of ourselves. The Pleiadians have watched over the development of our society and are still with us today, hoping that we can overcome the problems of our mixed heritage, and instead, use this rich diversity to our advantage. The Pleiadian Mission. Even though the mission to Earth had begun many years before, it was in the late 1600s when more than 250 Pleiadians came to Earth to observe our growth. They built an underground base in Switzerland to conceal their presence. Often they would walk among us, but in most cases they would observe us from the safety of their underground facility or gather information from their sophisticated flying beam ships. Unmanned craft called telemeter ships were used to monitor our languages and thought patterns. There were many lessons to be learned about the diverse cultures that were evolving here on Earth. The Pleiadians and their ancient ancestors, called Lyrans, have been aware of our planet for more than 22 million years, but this was the first time that they had come to Earth to observe and become involved with us. They could have come at any time, but it was clear to them that our civilization was beginning to develop and that an important time is coming which would lead to great change here on Earth. Having much greater knowledge of the universe than we do, the Pleiadians are aware that our planet is physically moving into a position where it will be greatly influenced by energies from the huge central sun of the galaxy. This happens because our solar system moves in a large orbit which brings us into this position every 25,860 years. This position that we are moving into causes our planet to pass through fields of energies generated by this powerful central sun. The effect is felt by the planet Earth and all life forms on it. Since few Earth scientists or religious leaders have any idea how these energies affect our thinking, it is fortunate our Pleiadian ancestors have decided to educate us. This position we are moving into is known to some as the Age of Aquarius, the spiritual era, the era of effective truth, enlightenment, love of knowledge, freedom, wisdom, and harmony. Unfortunately, all of these lessons will be earned through very difficult struggles. The Age of Aquarius will last 2,155 years, the same as the other constellations, and is repeated every 25,860 Earth years. As we move into this new time, we will have a window of opportunity for 800 years to achieve peace through spiritual growth and the understanding of creation. If we miss this opportunity to bring a more peaceful and spiritual way of life to our civilization, then the probability rapidly increases that we will fall into a deep and dark period controlled by illogical thinking and negativity. Historically, civilizations typically last for around 10,000 years. Ours is about 8,000 years old and is moving into its most difficult phase. This time of change, or new age, will be seen by spiritual people as a significant time of clarity, growth, and opportunity. However, the great mass of humanity is so caught up in the material struggle for life that they will perceive this as a time of despair, sorrow, and misery, because the mindset of the industrial age fails to provide the wisdom necessary to lead Earth into a new age of mind and spirit. A wonderful opportunity awaits those who have the vision to see the possibilities for peace and love on Earth. The beginning of the Age of Aquarius was on February 3, 1844 at 11:20 a.m. Previously the Earth was in the Age of Pisces, and then moved into the transition period between the two eras. The complete time for transition from Pisces to Aquarius is 186 years, therefore, at the beginning of the year 1937 the last vibrations of the Age of Pisces were overcome. The Aquarian began developing rapidly in its second phase of transition on February 1937 at 11:20 a.m. In the year 2030 the transition time will be complete, and our solar system will be suspended in and bathed with the gold-colored rays of the sign of Aquarius. Then after another 1,969 years, the X-constellation era of cosmic age will arrive. This will be on February 3, 3999 at 11:20 a.m., as our solar system moves into the area of the star sign of Capricorn. To the Pleiadians, with their vast knowledge of the energies of the universe and the effects they have on the consciousness of man, it was most important that they take this opportunity to lead man towards a new way of life, a path of spiritual understanding and harmony for the future. It is time for us, the people of Earth, to use our higher consciousness to sense the incoming energies and adjust to them, for the effects of these powerful energies cannot be underestimated or taken lightly. To begin with, it should be made very clear that the Age of Aquarius is not a time heralding the imminent destruction of the world, but the acceleration of spiritual awareness. Some religions and prophets have incorrectly interpreted the Age of Aquarius as the end of the world. This is quite inaccurate, for it will not be the end of the world, but the end of era of ignorance and the beginning of a new time of enlightenment and awareness. It will also be a wonderful and exciting time of new inventions, the development of mind and spirit, and increasing contact with other life in the universe. The coming rapid changes and discoveries in technology will alter the way we perceive life and the Earth with which we live. The 12 constellations. Because of the increase in energy from the central sun, the natural rate of development of our society is accelerating rapidly. Think of all of the wonderful inventions and changes we have already been exposed to in the past 100 years. We have come out of the age of the covered wagons, progressed through the industrialization of most of the world, and are moving out into space. Truly, we have made more advancements in the last 100 years than in the past 8,000. It is a most stimulating and challenging time to be alive. Spiritual people will see this as a great time of opportunity, for the increase in energy will accelerate personal growth and enlightenment. It is time for truth and understanding to find their way into our hearts and minds, and it is a time for us to discover new ideas and ways of thinking that will lead us into a new period of peace and understanding. We will discover our spiritual connection to creation and no longer have any need for misleading religious doctrines. It is a good time for prophets, teachers, and light workers. Because of the surge of energy that occurred on February 3, 1937 at 11:20 a.m., the Pleiadians believe that those with the most leadership potential for the new age were born on the first day of the changeover into the sign of Aquarius. Most of these spirits are among the oldest spirits on the earth plane and will most likely work in unseen ways, as they have no need for public acclaim. Many others were born during that year and will be among the teachers and leaders of this new period for Earth. This increase in the energies of higher consciousness on Earth is also helpful to the spirit forms on the other side, for it speeds up the turnaround time for them to return to physical life. Normally, the average turnaround time for a spirit form to return to material life is 152 years. During this present time of energy increase, the turnaround time can be as short as 15 years. It also facilitates the birth of much more highly evolved spirits to come into material life. The majority of people will see this as a period of chaos, and will have a very difficult time adjusting to the speed of the changes and to all of the new events that will be happening so quickly. One unfortunate part of these rapidly changing times is that many people will not be able to cope with the turmoil, and they will turn more and more to man-made belief systems and misleading religious doctrines for help, instead of seizing the opportunities to take responsibility for themselves. Spiritually conscious leaders will need patience, understanding, and mental balance in order to provide strength, love, and the appropriate role modeling. The basic teachings of religion, the Ten Commandments, provide the basis for a good, honest life. However, the problem lies with religious leaders who claim to be the mediators of God who provide the passageway to the doorway of heaven. As the coming times become more chaotic, you can expect many new religious sects to spring up that will take advantage of people's fear and lack of knowledge. Man must face up to being 100% responsible for his actions and his spiritual growth, for there is no God or other divine beings that will do it for him. A friend of mine once mentioned that there is a line being drawn in the sand of awareness. On one side we have the more enlightened and spiritual people who see the coming new age as a time of opportunity, leadership, and growth. And on the other side, we have the people who are not even aware of what is going on. As you look around and observe, you can see that this is true. Most people are consumed with personal problems and live in spiritual ignorance, contributing nothing to the growth of our society or creation, while others are trying to learn, understand, and grow during this wonderful time. Knowing the effects that the age of Aquarius energy will have on us and understanding the difficulties that face us as a civilization, the Pleiadians have chosen to help us with knowledge and understanding that can help us grow and evolve on the right path. They have built another underground base under Russia in order to become more involved in the development of Earth mankind. After years of careful analysis of our thoughts and studying the actions of our world leaders, they have decided that we need the words of truth in several areas to help us move peacefully into our future. What is the meaning of our lives? The Pleiadians feel that the most important information they can help us with surrounds the meaning and purpose of our lives. Probably no greater question mystifies the people of Earth more than this, and at some point in all of our lives we stop to reflect on the purpose of our existence. To those on a spiritual path, it seems almost pointless to be alive if we do not understand why we are living, while those living in a more material world seldom stop to even ask the question. It is the objective of religions and belief systems to offer an answer to this question. However, if you travel around the world, you can find as many answers as there are countries, for almost every religion and belief system has a different explanation as to why we are alive. Quite obviously, they cannot all be correct. As the world draws closer together through technology and communication, there seems to be an inevitable clash or gridlock approaching, whereupon the many answers to this question come face to face and can no longer avoid each other as they have in the past. From the view of the Pleiadians, they see us as a confused civilization that has turned to death and destruction too many times. In their eyes, the misleading explanations of some religions as to the meaning of our lives has served to keep people in the dark, causing confusion, wars, and bloodshed for thousands of years. There has been no greater loss of life on Earth than that caused by religious wars and persecution. The element of fear has been used all too often to control people and to prevent them from the personal discovery that is possible for anyone, the discovery of creation and its infinite logic which guides all things in the universe. The spiritual man who has set aside his ego to travel through the realms of consciousness can find the answer to life for himself. Here, creation can be discovered, and the spiritual bonding of all life forms can be felt. The understanding of the infinite spiritual energy can be realized, and the awareness of the purpose of the material consciousness becomes easier to see. For once spiritual existence is understood, the reason for material life becomes clear. We are spiritual beings, living through a series of material lives in order to feed our spirits through the wisdom learned from the material existence. It is the process of how spiritual development takes place and how we, individual spirit forms, contribute to the whole of creation and its evolution. The spirit needs the material senses to gather information and to form logic from experience. If the wisdom learned from these experiences is true according to creation and becomes part of the life of the individual, then it passes into the realm of the spirit and becomes part of the accumulated knowledge of the spirit form. This is what spiritual evolution is and why we are alive. Our technical advancements far outweigh our social development, and represent a clear and present danger to our future. This is the end of part 2. For more information about the Pleiadian mission, please visit thepleiadianmission.com. Again, please visit thepleiadianmission.com. Also subscribe and share this video. Let the whole world know the truth. Thank you for listening. Remember that knowledge is power. Please, don't be left in the dark. Please continue to part 3 in the next video.